Welcome back, guys, to another Tesla video. Today we have very large pieces of news, especially how recently Tesla stock has been doing extremely well, and in my opinion it's on track to hit $1,000 per share and having a $1 trillion market cap. Now that may seem kind of far-fetched, but a few months ago where I started talking about Tesla videos and also Tesla news, the stock was hovering at $400-$410. I said that the stock could definitely be reaching $700, $800, even $1,000 if Tesla gets some sort of a big stimulus to shock the stock and make it go up. Because at that time, over the course of several months, with the stock being completely flat around September and November, not much movement, a lot of really great and amazing news. You got like autopilot improvements, you got like the robo-taxis upcoming up, you got like the Tesla Semi and numerous gigafactories being set up. And the stock just simply wasn't moving at all. And finally, Tesla is joining the S&P 500. After the S&P 500 committee, they looked at it. They see Tesla is a lot more stable stock now. It's less volatile. They checked it. They liked it. It was the second time they reviewed Tesla stock. And now they're bringing Tesla stock back in. So we have a lot more upside after this S&P 500 welcome. We have Jim Cramer saying that Tesla will be going up even more because it joined the S&P 500. Now, one interesting thing about this, and the reason why it will be going up even more, even after this huge initial 60% surge after the announcement of joining, everyone will most likely own a portion of Tesla, whether they like it or not. There's a lot of companies in the S&P 500 that, if they weren't in the S&P 500, they'll be dropping like an absolute rock. But because so many people invest in ETFs, they buy the S&P 500 ETF. You got like Bridgewater Associates. One of their biggest holdings is the SPY ETF. Usually, fund managers do not beat the S&P 500. 50% of them don't. So this is why so many people invest in these ETFs. It's like a basket of stocks. SPY is the most popular one. If they commercialize and if they say that they track the S&P 500, they got to buy all the companies. Same thing with Tesla. If you guys don't want to own Tesla shares, too bad. You're going to have to own a small portion of it if you're buying a bunch of S&P 500 indexes. That's the reason why the stock will definitely go up even further. Because let's say I spend $1 million on SPY stock and not on Tesla stock. Tesla stock will still go up a little bit because I bought SPY stock. So it's a really big deal for Tesla joining the S&P 500. When the stock goes up further, we could even be seeing Tesla having another massive stock issue just to get more capital. And recently they did, which no one really knows what this $5 billion of cash they raised is used from. Total, they have roughly $20 billion in cash. And we could be seeing Musk probably making a brand new gigafactory, but that's not likely. We could be seeing Elon Musk buying another company, another EV company, or another car manufacturer. We also could be seeing Musk merging with someone else, buying someone out. So Musk has been saying this for a very long time. He's been teasing it. And I think the whole reason why you hold like $20 billion in cold hard cash is because you want to acquire some other car manufacturer. This is a pretty smart deal, especially how, for example, the Tesla Semi is a really good logistics truck. But Tesla at this current moment do not make electric buses. They do not make electric vans, etc. So I feel like they might acquire maybe a rival EV. And then they could provide the funding, maybe some sort of a gigafactory or microfactory, and they could start pumping out really good electric buses and really good electric vans, because you want to really diversify. Instead of just being in the consumer car business, Tesla's not reaching out into the semi-truck business. Now, once you're in the logistics business, you also want to diversify into other vehicles, like maybe buses, vans, maybe bigger cargo vans, etc. So there's a lot of really nice startups at this current moment worth only a few $1 billion, and Tesla could definitely snag it if they want to. And that's pretty big. And speaking of the semi-truck, this is by far one of the most hyped up vehicles I've ever seen, and no one has really talked about it. I've been saying that the Tesla Semi has really amazing stats, and this is going to be the main moneymaker of 2021. Everyone is looking at the Model 3. Everyone's looking at the Model X, you know, the Model S. But no one's looking at the Tesla Semi. No one really talks about this. And I really do feel like people are missing out. The reason why I feel like Tesla could definitely be hitting the $1 trillion mark sometime next year is simply because of the Tesla Semi truck. Logistics is a massive yearly industry in the US alone. We also could be seeing a lot of European countries buying the Tesla Semi. There are several companies at this current moment making some sort of electric semi. You got Daimler making electric semi trucks. You got BYD from China, somewhat making like a smaller variant. But the Tesla Semi is by far the best one. No other company seems to be making it. First of all, the Tesla Semi has a range of roughly 621 miles, which is a 24% increase over the earlier range of 500 miles. It recently got increased because Musk said that they are developing this brand new battery for the Semi truck. 500 miles per charge, it's pretty sweet, but 621 miles per charge, even better. And that means if, let's say, from my city to New York, it's like 800 miles, you probably only have to charge it once midway through. And that's pretty incredible. And speaking of charging, sure, you may make a semi truck, but keep in mind if you use the regular superchargers for everyday consumer vehicles, it takes 2 to 3 hours. And if a semi truck takes 2 to 3 hours to charge, massive delays in the logistics business. This is why Tesla is making a new, specific, even larger supercharger that is dedicated for electric semi trucks, but only for the Tesla brand. And Musk is already researching this, making these, and will be deploying these brand new Tesla Semi charging facilities to the rest of America in 2021. Because these new superchargers, made specifically for the large trucks, could charge it from 0 to 80 to 100% in less than 30 minutes. Now, 30 minutes would not delay any sort of logistic problem. So there you go. That's pretty big. I think the Tesla Semi truck is also pretty phenomenal because they're already under production. You already have so many EV startups claiming that they are making electric semi trucks. Sure, they might have made a couple vehicles here and there, some cool concepts and renders, but none of them have an actual factory. Not even Daimler has a factory. BYD is somewhat struggling, but they're doing okay. They're not really making the massive semi trucks like Tesla with an insane range. And these semi trucks will also be equipped with a lot of different sensors. And one day, this sounds pretty scary, we could be seeing semi trucks with no passengers or drivers in it. Imagine seeing a whole fleet of fully autonomous robo-taxi Tesla semis. That's the future, guys. This is pretty big. And I feel like the only person that's really going that route is Elon Musk. Even Walmart has ordered several Tesla semis. Look around. You don't really see any other company actually making a semi truck that's fully electric. Second, you don't really see anyone making the factory for these semi trucks. Third, no one is making the supercharger network that's dedicated for these massive trucks. And four, who has this many battery cells for these trucks? The amount of battery cells that the Tesla Semi takes is 7 times the normal Model 3. So obviously you need way more battery cell production, which Tesla has a Berlin Gigafactory and a Nevada Gigafactory for this issue. Thanks for watching, guys. Comment below. A lot more Tesla news is coming in. We do have Tesla joining the S&P 500. I guess if you now want to buy Tesla in a nice ETF, just buy SPY. Thanks for watching.